A very good morning to one and all. Children, this is your English language class and we are going to start a new topic today, which is articles. Okay? First of all, children, let me tell you all, there are only three articles, a, an, and the. Now you have to see that when do we use a, when do we use an, and when do we use the. Okay? So let's start. Articles. An article is a word that comes before a noun. The boy, a bee, an apple. As I told you children, we have three articles. A, an, and the. Alright? Let us see how to use it. When to use a, when to use an, and when to use the. We will begin with definite and indefinite article. Alright? That means the articles, these three articles are also divided in two parts. Definite, which article, which is the. Okay? The is the definite article. And a and an come under indefinite article. Alright? Now let us read about definite article and indefinite article, children. Definite, as the name tells you, children, definite means to be clear, exact, or obvious about something. It is called definite because it is used in relation to a particular thing or person. Alright? The is the definite article in English, which is used to refer to particular nouns, the identities of which are known. Okay? When we know about something, you know that we are talking about this particular thing or this particular person, then we use the. The definite article indicates that the noun is specific. The speaker talks about a particular thing. For example, the cat sat on the couch. Now here they're talking about that particular cat which is sitting on the couch. The dog attacked me and ran away. Here they're talking about that particular dog which attacked me and ran away. Alright? Let us see indefinite now, children. Indefinite means something which is not clear or obvious or exact. Okay? This is what the names tells you. Definite means to be clear, exact. Indefinite means to not be clear and not be exact. Alright? It is called indefinite because the identity of the person or thing being spoken about is left unclear or indefinite. It indicates that the noun is not someone or something in particular. The speaker talks about any one of that type of things. The indefinite articles in English are a and an. Let's see the example. Do you have a pencil? That means the one who's speaking this sentence means, do you have a pencil? Any pencil. Do you have a pencil? That person is not particular about a pencil. He is like any pencil. Alright? I want to have an apple. Any apple. He did not mention or he did not specify which apple or this particular apple. That person did not say that. He just said that I want to have an apple and I can have any apple. Alright? Not exact. Okay. Let us see the use again of a and an now, children. Alright? You have seen till now that the is a definite article and a and an comes under indefinite article. Alright? Now, when do we use a and when do we use an? This we are going to see now. A or a is used before the words beginning with the consonant sound. Okay? You have to be clear with the sound here. Alright? And what are consonants? There are 26 alphabets, children, in English, except vowels, except A, E, I, O, U. All the other letters are consonants, right? So the words which begin with a consonant letter or it begins with a consonant sound, you are going to put A before it, alright? And the words which begin with a vowel letter or a vowel sound, you are going to put an before it. Like A man, A lamb, a cat. Man starts with M, lamb starts with R, L, and cat starts with C. All these are consonants. Now when you come to an apple, an eraser, an umbrella. A, E, U. All these are vowels. All right. Let us see A and N a little more. A is used in front of singular countable nouns. The nouns you can count. All right. The nouns you can count, which are not specific. This we have seen, that A and N comes under indefinite articles, which are not specific, but countable nouns. We don't use a before uncountable or plural. A is used before singular and countable. If a noun starts with a consonant sound, A comes before the noun. Like a cat, a bird, a child, a doctor, a house, a bike, a boy, a table. An is used in front of singular countable nouns, which are not specific. Same. We don't use an before uncountable or plural nouns. That is also same with A and N. The only difference between A and N is consonant and vowel sounds. Alright. If the noun starts with a vowel sound, an comes before the noun. Like an apple, an egg, an ant, an orange. Now children, an R. Though this word R starts with H, and H is not a vowel, but H is silent in R, right? We say R. It is starting with a consonant sound of O, and O is a vowel, alright? So this is the reason we are putting an in front of R, because H is silent, alright? Don't forget, an aunt, an old uncle, and an uncle, alright? Now let us move to the definite article the. Before that, let us very quickly revise what we have seen till now. Definite and indefinite. Definite article is the, when you are very specific about something or you're exact. And indefinite is when you are not specific. And under that you have A and N. A is used before consonant sounds. N is used before vowel sounds. A and N both are used with singular countable nouns, alright? Singular countable nouns. The only difference is consonant sound and vowel sound, alright? Now we are going to see the definite article, which is the. The is used to give information about particular or known nouns, alright? Use of the in case of count and non-count nouns. That means the nouns which you can count and the nouns which you cannot count. The can either be used with non-countable nouns, the nouns which you cannot count, or the article can be omitted entirely. For example, she liked to sail over the water. Here, some specific body of water is being talked about. When you talk about particular water, she liked to sail over the water. When you're talking about that particular water, then you will use the. And if you're not talking about that particular thing, you are not using any article. And why? Because water is a noun which you cannot count, right? Which you cannot count. So when you cannot count that, you cannot use A and N. Either you are using the or you're not using any article at all. She liked to sail over water. Now here, when you are not clear about particular water, you are not using any article, all right? No particular water is being talked about. It can refer to any water. Alright. So then we are not using any article. Because we have seen that A and N is used with countable nouns. Singular and countable nouns. Alright. Let us see this definite article the a little more. The definite article is the word the. It is used before a noun to specify it as something previously considered. Use the after you have talked about it the first time. Like this is a dog. The dog is brown. Now we are talking about the same dog again. So we used the. Use the when the person you are talking to already knows what you are talking about. Okay, I am going to the bank. Like the person to whom I am talking. I am assuming that that person knows which bank I am talking about. So I used the here. There is someone knocking at the door. It must be the computer repairman. I know it must be the computer repairman, so I've used the. Use the when you talk about general places in nature, like the lake, the mountains, the ocean, the beach. Alright, let's go to the beach. I love to camp in the mountains. Use the when you're talking about something that there is only one of. and everyone knows about it. The sky, the earth, the stars. How many people are there on the earth? The sky is so beautiful today. Alright, children? So, the is used when you are specific about something, when you know that the person to whom you are talking knows about that. Alright? So, we have seen this difference. We have seen definite article, indefinite. Definite is the, indefinite is a and an. Definite article is used with, you can use it with uncountable nouns also. And indefinite are only used with singular and countable nouns. Alright? Sorry. Now we can see your book. The words a or an and the are called articles. The word the points out some particular person or thing. Therefore, it is called a definite article. The words a or an leaves indefinite the person or thing spoken of. Therefore, it is called indefinite articles. He wants a dictionary, means any dictionary. He wants the dictionary, means some particular dictionary he is talking about. Okay? We use indefinite article a before those words that begin with a consonant sound. A fan, a dog, a book, a cat, and so on. We use indefinite article an before those words that begin with the vowel sound. You have so many examples in front of you. Alright? We use a or an only before singular and countable nouns. We also use the indefinite article a in the sense of one, like wait a minute. When we're talking about 1 minute, we use that wait a minute. 1,000 people were there, which means 1,000. All right now let us see very quickly the with the names of rivers, the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Nile, with the names of oceans and seas, with the names of mountain ranges, with the names of historical monuments, with the names of certain books, with the names of things being the only ones of their kind. The universe, the sun, the earth. Alright children, so we will be discussing it more in the class. We will be doing book exercises. Okay, and that will help you understand the use of articles a and the all the more better. Till then everybody, have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.